Today marks the second day since embattled events organizer Abby Musingzi, commonly known as Abitex, was put behind bars over the Freedom City tragedy that left 10 people dead. Abitex's legal team, led by the Kampala Lord Mayor Erias Lukwago, have today engaged the security operatives at the Central Police Station in Kampala, demanding for his release or to be produced in courts of law. This engagement was, however, not open to the media.
We have demanded that he be produced in court. Unfortunately, they have told us they are still looking for some other suspects and the file is not ready, that the earliest they can do it is tomorrow. So we are going to continue pushing that he be taken to court, because we are wondering, we are asking ourselves, if he was on a police bond, he had not breached any of the conditions of the bond, why rearrest him?
Lukwago insisted that Abitex's arrest was not justified.
We are really concerned and we take exception of the way they have handled it by simply picking Abitex without any justifiable reason. We told you on the night of that fateful incident, he was picked, he was taken to police, he recorded a statement, and indeed he was granted a police bond. So he has been on a police bond since that night, and he hadn't breached any of the conditions for that particular bond.
Lukwago has pointed out reasons why Abitex was not the right person to be arrested, and he says the security operatives who were on duty on that day at Freedom City should have foreseen the stampede and taken punitive action. Therefore, they should be the ones to be detained for having been reluctant. It's not Abitex who organized fireworks, which partly contributed to the death of people. Therefore, it should be the premise owners to account for people's death. Abitex had already been given a police bond. Why was he rearrested? Lukwago says the arrest was segregated and other parties were left out, pointing out the owner and manager of Freedom City.
In all this war process, there were different key players. The owner had a role, had a duty to play, occupier's liability. In the law, we have that doctrine of occupier's liability. The first person who is culpable in this is the owner of the premises. Because by the mere fact that he designed this structure, he made it in such a way that it would host multitudes of people, he ought to have foreseen that such calamities would happen and contingencies should have been put in place. So by the mere fact that he didn't put in place those particular contingencies, he's culpable.
Event promoter Balam Barugahara has vowed that they will not rest until one of their own gets justice, citing a fair arrest.
They are putting a blame on the organizer, but the organizer may have a limited link or blame on that matter. The entire thing lie in the hands of the entire problem lie in the hands of the venue owner, who have 5 doors on the building but decided to open 1 door and put Solex padlocks, unbreakable fireproof padlocks on an arena housing people. This is an instance that could have been avoided if those doors at 10 p.m. were opened, so that by midnight everyone knows we shall be having fireworks outside, so people keep going out earlier.
He has advised that Freedom City remains just a mall until owners make adjustments to it to fully suit the standards of venues for concerts.
Let us also choose the locations for our events carefully. We should avoid doing such scenario where we don't open. I will give you a good example of Sheraton. It has 4 entrances in and out. Then the other venue is Lubiri Mengo, Kabaka's Palace. It has almost 7 entrances. So such venues, we can't get such incidences. Resort Beach Entebbe has 4 gates.
The Territorial Police in Kampala Metropolitan South and Katwe Division arrested the promoter over a New Year concert at Freedom City Hall that led to a stampede that killed 10 concert goers. The incident happened on January 1st, 2022, at around midnight at Freedom City in Namasuba, where about 400 revelers and concert goers were celebrating the end of the year and welcoming the new year. Investigations by police into the tragedy are still ongoing. Report by Jaliet Namoya for the news.